I will start with my today's lecture. So if we'll see, in last lecture we have seen mica insulating material. I told you to draw memory map also, and you had drawn very good memory map. All of you drawn a very good memory map, and also we talk on that how we can create memory map. No assignment is given on memory map. You just simply think five materials. Will you draw separate memory map or only one memory map can be sufficient, so that properties, applications, and types or classification of these five materials you can remember very easily in one memory map. Suppose permittivity. So permittivity is common for all materials. So if you will just write down permittivity point and the values of all five materials, I think that way you will able to recall it in a good way, easy way, you think, and then create memory map. Means five material you have to create, means it doesn't mean that five memory maps you have to create. It can be one memory map, five materials. So start thinking on assignments, complete it, and then be ready for the test. So in last lecture we have seen mica, properties of mica, applications of mica, types of mica. So I will cover today asbestos. So let us start with asbestos. Learning by doing exercise, we have seen in last time. So asbestos, if you see, just mute yourself. Somebody is Maithili, mute yourself. Maithili?
Ma'am, I'm already muted.
Then whose sound is there?
Rutuja, mute yourself.
Yes, Rutuja, mute yourself. So asbestos, if you see, it is a mineral, but fibrous material. Now you have understood, because we have seen fibrous material. So fibrous material, we have seen that they have small diameters and just like threads. So asbestos can be in fibrous form, and it's a mineral. It withstands at about 400 degrees Celsius. So temperature, it can withstand 400 degrees Celsius. It is hygroscopic in nature and need impregnation, because hygroscopic means it have a chance that it will absorb moisture. So impregnation is required, and we have discussed what is impregnation, varnish treatment, oil treatment, so that moisture will not be absorbed and dielectric strength of material will increase. So asbestos required impregnation. It is found in Andhra Pradesh, means if you will see, asbestos is also available in India. Cost and grade of asbestos depends upon length of fiber. Naturally, because as it is a fibrous material, how long it is, cost will depend upon that, and grade also, grade of asbestos. It has low dielectric properties and then mica. If you see mica, mica is strong, and therefore it is used in rotating devices due to high wear and tear resistance also. But this asbestos is having less dielectric strength of than compared to mica. So what will be applications of asbestos? It will be used in form of cloth. So asbestos cloth is there, paper is there, board is there, rope is there. In tape form also it is there. Asbestos tapes are also available, and they can be used in low voltage applications. Asbestos tapes can be used for equipment working at high temperature. Low voltage, but can be high temperature. It is also used as end turn insulation. End turn means at the end, traction motors. So if you see traction motor windings are there, and windings are also having end terminals. So at the end terminal, this asbestos bands can be used. Means just winding at the end, you have to wound it, that turn, end terminal of the winding. At that time, you will insulate with asbestos. Okay, and also automobile starting motor, or in electric motors and generators, but not in the rotating parts like commutators, but it will be used mainly in winding bandings. At the end, it is used in commutator segment separators. Separators, now I have shown you the commutator. Two commutator segments are there, separators are also there. So asbestos tape can be used. It is used in a layer insulation in transformation. So layered insulation, it can be used, because layer to layer there has to be separation, and what separation insulating material you will keep between layer to layer, asbestos eukaryotes. Asbestos cement is also used in switch gears and arcing devices. So switch gears means it will be switching devices, like a simple switch. It is switching. So whenever switching occurs, arc will take place. And arcing devices also arc will take place. So asbestos will be used. It is used as arcing barriers in switches and circuit breakers. So here are the some applications of asbestos board. So you can see this is asbestos board, or this coating can be of also asbestos. This will be also coating of the asbestos will be used in the fuse, or you can see this fibrous asbestos also will be used here. Asbestos paper and board with cotton backing can be used in form of boards and sleeves in heating devices. Sleeves manje kay? Tar wire la like tumhi particularly if you have seen in iron press, that wire or cable of the press is having some sleeves. Means wire will be covered with the another layer of insulating material. So that is called as sleeves. And in heating devices, means iron, asbestos is used widely. It is used in electrical heating and cooling equipment. It is also used in dielectrics of some capacitors. Means capacitor asbestos also it is used. It is used for armature binding. That already told you, binding means at the last terminal. Two types of asbestos are there. You can see chrysotile and amphibole. So just you can see this asbestos, use of asbestos. I forgot to share the sound. 1 minute later, I will just redo sharing. in next lecture, we'll see impregnating coating materials, fillers, and then we'll start with air insulating material. Almost solid insulating materials we have covered. So now we will request, Arushi is there? Whether Arushi is there? Arushi?
Yes, ma'am, I'm here. Yes, ma'am.
So can you call your mother?
Yes, ma'am. Just a second.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, madam. Dear students, now as already I have told you that we are having today expert lecture of Arushi's mother. So I would like to introduce her first. Mrs. Neetu Gupta is here with us today, and she is working with social sector, and also she is enjoying that work. She has done B.Ed. from Kurukshetra University. Then she has done Master's in Science in Counseling and Psychotherapy. She has also done Master's degree in Social Work from the University of Delhi. And Psychotherapy and Counseling she has done from Mumbai University. I think you have vast experience of different universities. Then graduation, she has done BSc Home Science from University of Delhi, and short-term course also she has done in remedial teaching for children with learning disability. She also has life skills coaching. She is doing working as life skill coaching, career counseling, and resilience training for the students since 10 to 16 years. She is also conducting teachers training programs, workshops on teaching methodology and curriculum development, multi-level instructional strategies and classroom management also. Then she is also providing counseling services to the students, teachers, parents regarding exam stress, psychological and social adjustments in the school. So, dear students, I think that Arushi's mother will also contribute a lot. Now, just she has started within first month contributing for our development. So, I hope you will also not hesitate to contact her because she is classmate. Arushi is your classmate and friend, and parent is with us. So, don't hesitate to talk with your difficulties for your counseling, any stress issues. And I will also request Mrs. Neetu Gupta that you can also contribute with the students solving problems and this. Today she will give lecture on self-awareness, which is very important. Just now students are doing planning for this term and planning for the 3 years. And I think it will be very helpful. So I welcome madam, and you can start. First, I would like to take one snap. Dear students, you make your video on. You make video on, and just two, three students, Amay Kulkarni and Videha, you can take snaps. Students, make your video on. We'll take photo. Students, make your video on. Now somebody can take photo.
Why can't we see it?
Amay Kulkarni, you take one snap. Videha, two, three students, you can take snap, because now we can take snaps like this only for our online. What to do?
online group, WhatsApp group.
So Amay, have you taken photo?
Yes, ma'am. I have sent it on the WhatsApp group. Material.
Okay,
group.
Madam, you can start.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Stop my sharing. Yes.
Yes.
Stop it.
Thank you so
dear
much.
Students, you can make a video off. Madam, you can keep yours on. Yes, all of the students can make video off. Yes, madam, please.
Okay, thanks. There is a lot to say, but I'll start with one thing that I am really super excited, super glad that I've got this opportunity to interact with young learners, with children who are not children as such. They are young learners who are just in the threshold of their professional expertise. So I have tried to concise this topic into few slides. There are 11 slides, about 11 slides, because self-awareness is a very vast topic. You must have heard this self-awareness for number of years. You should be self-aware, self-disciplined. So what I've done is basically I've taken more of things which you need to work on yourself as the parameter. So we will discuss this self-awareness, that what do you mean by self-awareness? How do you develop these skills of self-awareness according to your expertise? So I would like to share the slides with you. The first slide which comes. I hope I'm audible to everybody. Can you please tell me whether I'm audible or not?
Yes.
Yes.
Fine. You
can. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the first thing which I would like to tell you is that you're all electrical students. You're doing your engineering in electronics, electrical science. So the first thing which you should all know is that our brain is a very complex electrical circuit. You all know that. You must have studied your biology also in your 10th standard. And you must be knowing this thing that neurons, they are connected in circuits. So the first thing as a neuroscientist, what we are taught is that if your brain is healthy, if your brain is functioning in a optimum level, your microcircuits which help you to process the information are in proper order, you can excel. All your senses, whether it is your smell, whether it is your taste, everything depends. All five senses also depend upon your neurons. So if you have a healthy brain, if you have a brain which functions well, you can excel in whatever field you want to do. Now, let's go to the next slide.
Arushi, can you make a PPT, a slide presentation?
It's not visible. It's in presentation mode itself. Okay, then continue. Now, since we are dealing with children who are millennials, who are Generation Z learners, I would not have a monotony of lecturing. I mean, I would not like to lecture them on self-awareness and give them a big lecture on this, which is of no utility. Because knowledge, until it is not practiced, it is of no utility. So I would like to start my session with a fun game. This is just a small game. Whatever is the adjective of your first letter of your name, you have to write one adjective of your first letter of your name. Which means that if my name is Neetu, I have to write Neetu is equal to neat, right? Now open your chat boxes, all of you, and write one adjective. First you write your name, and secondly you write your that adjective which suits your name, which reflects you, which you feel is a representation of myself, me. So please open your chat boxes and write the adjective which represents your name, your personality, you as a whole. So please do this exercise. I'll give you 15 minutes for that. Open chat box and write that. So are we doing that activity? Can I have the feedback, please? Are we done with it?
Yes, they have started responding. Tejas, okay. Amazing. Then Kunal, kind. Maithili, Mudi.
Okay.
Sushmita, smart.
Very good.
Rutuja, humble. Prasad Very patient.
Nice. Okay. Okay, are we through with it? Are we done with it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now you will think that why I made you do this exercise, why did I tell you to write one adjective which is representative of your name? The simple reason behind is that it's very important how we perceive ourselves, how we think we are. And the first reaction, the first word which comes in our mind is a reflective of what we feel we are. Because our emotions, our personality traits, our values, our habits, and all our psychological feelings are connected to us. I would also use Hindi in my discussion when I'm having this interaction with you. Because mujhe ye pata hai ki hum log bilingual hai, all of us are bilingual. We think in Hindi, Marathi, and English. Most of us think in our mother language and then we translate into English. So, मैं दोनों चीजों का दोनों भाषाओं का प्रयोग करूंगी और उम्मीद करती हूँ अगर आपको कभी भी कोई डाउट है तो प्लीज रेज योर हैंड जैसे भी आपका जो भी इंफॉर्मेशन देने का तरीका है मुझे बताइए कि आपको इसमें कुछ डाउट है तो मैं आपका डाउट भी क्लैरिफाई करूंगी दैट इज नॉट अ प्रॉब्लम अब हम लोगों को अपने बारे में जानकारी अपनी सेल्फ अवेयरनेस की होनी चाहिए क्योंकि जो भी हमारी साइकोलॉजिकल प्रोसेसेस हैं जो हमारी एबिलिटी है जजमेंट करने की वो बहुत कुछ डिपेंड करती है कि हम अपने बारे में क्या सोचते हैं हमारे सिग्निफिकेंट अदर्स हमारे बारे में क्या सोचते हैं ओके नाउ आई विल गो टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड जस्ट अ मिनट आई मीन आई एम नॉट सो गुड इन कंप्यूटर सो आई हैव असिस्टेंट हु इज हेल्पिंग मी आउट
अरे असिस्टेंट क्या देती हूँ आपके
So, okay, the third slide. Now, इसको मैंने I have tried to make a pictorial diagram of what self-awareness means. कि हम अपने कहते हैं कि हमारे को कई बार हमें बोलते हैं पेरेंट्स बोलते हैं कई बार हमारे को बहुत से लोग बोलते हैं इंट्रोस्पेक्ट करो रिफ्लेक्ट करो अपने ऊपर कि तुम्हारे में क्या प्रॉब्लम्स हैं और तुम कैसे इम्प्रूव कर सकते हो इम्प्रूवमेंट के बारे में सब बोलते हैं एवरीबडी टॉक्स अबाउट इम्प्रूवमेंट बट नोबडी टेल्स हाउ टू इम्प्रूव दैट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज मोस्ट ऑफ अस आर इग्नोरेंट टू द फैक्ट दैट हाउ वी हैव टू इम्प्रूव तो इफ वी टॉक अबाउट सेल्फ अवेयरनेस क्या है हम अपने बारे में कैसे जानकारी ले सकते हैं हम क्या हैं हम किस किस प्रकार के पदार्थ से बने हुए हैं हम जो होते हैं बचपन में पैदा होते हैं उसके बाद हम बहुत से बिहेवियर्स ऐसे होते हैं जो हम लर्न करते हैं कॉल्ड लर्न बिहेवियर इन साइकोलॉजी यानी हमने लर्न किया है हमने अपने पापा को गुस्सा करता देखा तो हमने लर्न किया और हमने सोचा कि गुस्सा करना एक्सेप्टेबल है हमने अपनी मदर को चुप होते हुए देखा तो हमने सोचा कि शायद लड़कियों को चुप रहना होता है ये एक लर्न बिहेवियर है जो हमने लर्न कर लिया हमारे अधिकतर बिहेवियर्स जो होते हैं वो लर्न बिहेवियर होते हैं राइट अब हम बनते किससे हैं हम बनते हैं अपनी स्किल्स से आप देखेंगे पूरा डायग्राम बता रहा है इसमें स्किल्स क्या होती हैं इसके बारे में मैं बाद में भी डिस्कशन करूंगी पहले मैं पर्सनालिटी लेती हूँ कि पर्सनालिटी क्या होती है पर्सनालिटी में आप देखिए बहुत सारे कॉम्पोनेंट्स हैं जिससे हमारी पर्सनैलिटी बनती है पूरे डिटेल में नहीं जाऊँगी बट ये बोलूँगी कि जो हम अपनी दिमाग में अपनी कॉग्निशन में जो चीज़ें प्रोसेस करते हैं जैसे प्रोसेस करते हैं जो हमारी थिंकिंग एबिलिटी होती है वो हमारी पर्सनालिटी को बहुत कुछ बनाती है और उसके बाद आता है नॉलेज एंड इंटरेस्ट यानी हमारा नॉलेज किस में है हम किस चीज़ की इस फील्ड में चले गए जैसे मैं चली गई सोशल साइंटिस्ट की फील्ड में मैंने सोशल साइंस पढ़ा तो मैं हर चीज़ को एक अलग एंगल से देखती हूँ जिसमें बिहेवियर जिसमें सोशल एलिमेंट्स होते हैं आप चले गए एक टेक्निकल फील्ड में तो आप सब चीज़ें देखते हैं एक टेक्निकल एंगल से साइंस के एंगल से देखते हैं तो ये जो नॉलेज और इंटरेस्ट हो मेरा इंटरेस्ट है जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल मैं बहुत नेचर लविंग हूँ मेरा बहुत नेचर के साथ प्यार है तो मैं हर चीज़ को जो देखूंगी अपना जो नज़रिया होगा या अपनी जो मेरा जो थिंकिंग होगा वो उसी के साथ ही एकदम अटैच्ड होगा ठीक है नेक्स्ट हमारी वैल्यूज अब हम जिस परिवार में पैदा होते हैं जिस परिवार में पलते बढ़ते हैं, जो हम चीज़ें लर्न, मैंने आपको बताया लर्न बिहेवियर जो हम एक्वायर करते हैं अपने कल्चर, वो भी हमारे को हमारा डेफिनेशन देने में बहुत हाथ रखता है कि हम क्या हैं. और बहुत कुछ ये चीज़ें जो हैं बचपन में आपके माता पिता ने जब आपको पाला है तो किस तरीके से इनकरेजमेंट से पाला है, आपको कितनी कॉन्फिडेंस से पाला है, उससे भी बहुत डिपेंड करेगा. अब मैं चाहती हूँ अपनी थर्ड स्लाइड पे, ओके फोर्थ स्लाइड पे. अब ये आप सबके लिए, क्योंकि आप लोग टेक्निकल नॉलेज गेन कर रहे हैं और आगे चल के मैं जो आपको देख रही हूँ कि एवरीबडी ऑफ यू विल बी एजिंग, विल बी आइंग करियर इन एंड अराउंड लॉट ऑफ कंप्यूटिंग, टेक्निकल लैंग्वेज एंड आप लोग बहुत वो जो लैंग्वेजेस होते हैं C++ क्या क्या करेंगे आगे चलकर. तो मेगा सिक्स के लिए दैट आप अगर सक्सेसफुल होना चाहते हैं तो बहुत ज़रूरी है थिंकिंग स्किल्स. ये जो थिंकिंग स्किल्स हैं, ये जो बच्चे आईवी बोर्ड में पढ़ते हैं, बिकॉज मैं आईवी बोर्ड के टीचर्स को भी ट्रेन कर चुकी हूँ और CBSE और ICSE के भी बोर्ड्स को ट्रेन कर चुकी हूँ, तो 12वीं तक जो आईबी के बच्चे हैं उनकी थिंकिंग स्किल्स मस्ट डेवलप्ड होती हैं, क्योंकि वो पहले से ही थिंकिंग स्किल्स पे काम करना शुरू करते हैं. अब थिंकिंग स्किल्स होती क्या है, तो आप सोचेंगे थिंकिंग स्किल्स क्या है. थिंकिंग स्किल्स क्या होती है, एक रैशनल जजमेंट, एक रीजनिंग होती है हर चीज़ की. अब आप पढ़ रहे हैं, मान लीजिए एक टॉपिक, लेट्स सपोज एक मटेरियल साइंस का टॉपिक पढ़ रहे हैं, आप क्यों पढ़ रहे हैं, उसकी रीजनिंग क्या है, ठीक है. आपको उसके साथ एक साइकोलॉजिकल एसोसिएशन करना होता है और रिफ्लेक्ट करना होता है, ये इसकी, इसका हम जो कर रहे हैं इसके साथ हम कौन सी प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व करेंगे. थिंकिंग स्किल्स बेसिकली आपको अल्टीमेटली प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग तक लानी चाहिए. इतनी आपका रैशनल थिंकिंग, इतना रैशनैलिटी डेवलप कर देनी चाहिए आपकी थिंकिंग के अंदर कि आपको पता चल जाए कि हम ये पढ़ रहे हैं तो अल्टीमेटली इसकी यूटिलिटी क्या होती है. अब देखिए थिंकिंग स्किल्स का एक बहुत बड़ा डायग्राम दिया है मैंने और उसमें सब बताया है कि कैसे कैसे प्रोसेसेस होते हैं थिंकिंग स्किल्स में. और एक मैंने साइड में जो लेफ्ट साइड में जो लिखा है वो यह है, थिंकिंग स्किल्स मेजर्स योर एबिलिटी इन क्रिटिकल थिंकिंग एंड प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग स्किल्स विच आर एसेंशियल फॉर योर हायर एजुकेशन. आप में से जो बच्चे आगे चल के फॉरेन यूनिवर्सिटीज में अपना पढ़ना चाहते हैं आगे फर्दर एजुकेशन के लिए, आफ्टर योर ग्रेजुएशन, आफ्टर योर BE इज कम्प्लीट, ये बात आप बहुत ध्यान से सुनिए मेरी, कि आगे चल के जो आप TSA टेस्ट देंगे जो कि कैम्ब्रिज यूनिवर्सिटी में, ऑक्सफोर्ड में और UCL में होता है, उसमें थिंकिंग स्किल्स के ऊपर भी एक कंप्यूटर बेस्ड असेसमेंट होता है. तो ये जो कंप्यूटर बेस्ड असेसमेंट होता है थिंकिंग स्किल्स में, इसमें आपको अपनी थिंकिंग स्किल्स के बारे में, यानी ये जो मैंने लिखी है पूरे डायग्राम में जो स्किल्स लिखी हैं, इनके बारे में आपको पूरा अवेयरनेस होना चाहिए, पूरा पता होना चाहिए कि ये थिंकिंग स्किल्स आपको कैसे हेल्प करेंगी. ये एक बहुत बड़ा टॉपिक है थिंकिंग स्किल्स में. मैं पूरी एक हफ्ते की वर्कशॉप ले सकती हूँ थिंकिंग स्किल्स में, क्योंकि थिंकिंग स्किल्स एक ऐसा चीज़ है जिसको डेवलप करने में बहुत टाइम लगता है. हमारे बच्चे जो स्कूल लेवल में थिंकिंग स्किल्स में नहीं पढ़ाए जाते हैं, उनको बहुत डिफिकल्टी होती है आगे चलकर जब वो TSA के लिए बैठते हैं. और इसके लिए आपको अभी से ही थिंकिंग स्किल्स में बहुत सारे, आप अगर खोलेंगे YouTube वगैरह, उसमें थिंकिंग स्किल्स के ऊपर बहुत सारे वीडियोस हैं, आप उनको देखिए, उनको ब्राउज कीजिए, उनको देखिए कि कैसे ये थिंकिंग स्किल्स डेवलप करनी है. बिकॉज मैंने आपको ये बताया, एवरी थिंकिंग स्किल्स शुड लीड टू प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग. एंड ये अगर आप कर सकते हैं अभी से ही इसको डेवलप करेंगे तो बहुत अच्छा रहेगा. ओके नेक्स्ट वी मूव टू द नेक्स्ट वन, लर्निंग स्टाइल. अब ये लर्निंग स्टाइल भी बेसिकली जब हम लेते हैं, मैं टीचर्स को और जो प्रिंसिपल्स और जो बच्चों को लेती हूँ वो स्कूल लेवल पे लेती हूँ, बट मैंने सोचा कि ये आपके साथ भी एक बार लूँ, बिकॉज ये बहुत ज़रूरी है कि हमें ये पता हो कि हमारा लर्निंग स्टाइल क्या है. मीन्स हम कैसे पढ़ते हैं, हमारे लिए पढ़ना कैसा उचित है, कैसे हमारी लर्निंग होती है, ठीक है. आप कैसे लर्निंग होती है, कुछ बच्चे फॉर एग्जाम्पल होते हैं जो नोटबुक जब टीचर पढ़ा रही है तो नोट्स लेना प्रेफर करते हैं, कुछ बच्चे सिर्फ सुनना प्रेफर करते हैं और उनके मेमोरी में, उनके दिमाग में वो चीज़ें आती हैं और उनको समझ में आती हैं. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट जब हम लर्निंग स्टाइल की बात करते हैं, वी डिवाइड दीज लर्निंग स्टाइल्स इनटू 3 काइंड्स, विजुअल, ऑडिटरी एंड किनेस्थेटिक. नाउ विजुअल इज थ्रू ऑब्जर्वेशन, एज एवरीबडी नोज. आई विल टेल यू अ वेरी सिंपल एग्जाम्पल. आई हैव अ 2 डॉटर्स एंड एल्डर वन विच इज स्टार्टिंग विद यू had a very good observation, and I assessed this during her childhood years that whenever we used to pass by even one lane, and she used to observe a lot of things, and she used to tell me, is this the place where there was a hoarding, there was a hotel, and she would remember the names also. So that means at that time I assessed that she's a visual learner, and she will, whenever she will observe things, see, looking and observing are two different things. They're two different mental processes altogether. So when you are a visual learner, you observe things and then you also remember those things. Few of us are auditory learners. As it has been written also, the slide itself shows that when you are hearing things, hearing means not hearing as a process, listening things, then you understand those things, right? And the third one is the kinesthetic. Kinesthetic style of learning is also that you involve your body along with that. Like few of us, when I'm talking about notes taking, what are you doing? You're involving your fingers, your writing, right? These things are kinesthetic things. So you should be aware of your learning style. कि आप कैसे लर्न करते हो. अगर आप बैठकर सारा दिन किताब खोल के बैठते हैं और सिर्फ उसको रट्टा मार रहे हैं और उससे कुछ आपको याद नहीं हो रहा, दैट्स अ टोटल वेस्ट ऑफ टाइम. नाउ बिकॉज यू नो व्हाट हैपेंस इज व्हेन यू आर अवेयर ऑफ दिस स्ट्रेंथ कि आपका लर्निंग स्टाइल क्या है, आप कैसे पढ़ सकते हैं, तो बहुत इजी हो जाता है. जैसे अभी फॉर एग्जांपल वी फ्यू डेज बैक वी हैड अ डिस्कशन कि अभी मैम सिर्फ थ्योरेटिकल हो रहा है और स्लाइड्स होती हैं, बच्चे पढ़ रहे हैं, कोई लैब है नहीं, बच्चे जो हैं बिना लैब के क्या करेंगे, एक्सपेरिमेंट्स तो हो नहीं सकते. वी नो इट्स अ डिफिकल्ट टाइम, वी नो इट्स अ पेंडेमिक, अभी सब लोग, इट्स फर्स्ट द सर्वाइवल ऑफ द फिटेस्ट वाला फिलोसफी हो रहा है. इफ वी कैन सर्वाइव देन वी कैन गो अहेड. So my conclusion was that अभी तो entire world is a lab. पूरी दुनिया एक lab की तरह है आपके लिए. सब कुछ आपके लिए open है, पूरा web खुला हुआ है. There are lot of things जो आप web से पढ़ सकते हो. Learning has no limitations if you want to learn. Nobody can impede learning. So students have a lot of experience. पूरी ideology, पूरा knowledge base खुला हुआ है. So there are no limitations. So learning style, अगर आपको अपना पता है कि मैं अपना टाइम वीडियोस में यूट्यूब में जाऊंगी और ये देखूंगी अपना ये टॉपिक जो टीचर ने पढ़ाना है पहले ही अगले दिन प्रिपेयर करके बैठूंगी, तो फिर उसका तो आपको कोई limitations है ही नहीं. But that is your self-awareness, whether you know your learning style, whether you have the will to do it or not. So let me move to the next slide. Nowadays we talk about agile learners. कहते हैं कि अभी pandemic है, everybody has their own pandemic blues. हम लोगों को अभी as educators we have a pandemic blue that हम बच्चों को अभी one to one पढ़ा नहीं पा रहे हैं and we have to use technology as a connect to our students. But I think everybody apart from us, people have their own issues. Like few have livelihood issues also, few have survival issues. Because it is a difficult time, all of us know that difficult times need different strategies. So if we have a dream, abhi agar hamara dream hai ki hame apne engineering acche se karna hai and we have to go further ahead with the studies, go outside India or within India we have to excel and we have a dream company in our mind that we have to basically get a job into our dream company. So then no limitations. Learning agility is referred to as लर्निंग एजिलिटी कहते हैं, जो फास्ट लर्नर होता है, जैसे भी सिचुएशन हो वो फटाफट अपने आप को इक्विप करके लर्निंग फास्ट कर लेता है. इन दिस पेंडेमिक टाइम, इन दिस कोविड टाइम्स, व्हेन एवरीथिंग इज सो इनडिसाइसिव, कभी लॉकडाउन हो रहा है, कभी लॉकडाउन नहीं हो रहा, वन थिंग वी हैव टू कीप इन माइंड इज दैट वी हैव अ लॉन्ग टर्म गोल ऑफ स्टडिंग एंड वी विल, हम लोगों को अपना जो इंजीनियरिंग है वो अच्छे से करना है. एंड फॉर लर्निंग एजिलिटी व्हाट डू वी नीड सेल्फ मैनेजमेंट, कम्युनिकेशन, थिंकिंग, रिसर्च एंड सोशल स्किल्स आल्सो. या सोशल स्किल्स आई वुड लाइक टू से कि बहुत से बच्चे ऐसे होते हैं जो इंटरेक्ट ही नहीं करना चाहते हैं, बहुत करते नहीं हैं बिकॉज दे फील दैट हम इंटरेक्ट करेंगे तो लोग हमारा मजाक उड़ाएंगे या कुछ कहेंगे. सो दैट इज नॉट अ इम्पिडिमेंट, दैट्स नॉट अ डिफिशियंसी एट ऑल, दैट्स नॉट अ लिमिटेशन एट ऑल. ये आपके अंदर होता है बिकॉज ये कोई दूसरा इसको परसीव नहीं कर सकता. So then in COVID times, I have tried to figure out that what skills do you need, that you need interactive skills, language skills, critical thinking and all. This you can see, the slide is there. I'm going to basically talk about the utility of these slides because they look very nice when we look at them, colorful slides. But how do you use these slides? These are all words, all bombastic words which are used by people. But iska humne usage kahan karna hai, wohi hume samajh mein nahi aata. Now I come to the main topic, that is SWOT analysis. आप जब हम SWOT analysis की बात करते हैं, ये काम आपको अपना खुद करना है. This is an analysis for yourself. This is for your own sake. It's totally a voluntary work for yourself. If you want to do it, that will benefit you because now will you sit with yourself for 10-15 minutes and do this work. This you can do afterwards and share it with the teacher, and she can also help you because this SWOT analysis will be very helpful for you to figure out your challenges, your limitations, your strengths, and in your career planning, how will you use yourself as a resource. So tools that we use when we analyze things, when we want to know ourselves, is called a SWOT analysis. The SWOT analysis is used to evaluate your strengths, weakness, opportunities, and threats. What do we call as strengths, right? See, if you see this, there are few things which are internal. I have tried to figure out this thing also for you, that strengths and weaknesses within you. These are all your internal, innate things, right? Now, I have also seen people who would like to know what do you mean by word strength? Strength hota kya hai? So strength is the ability to do things that we need to do. This may be physical or mental. Kuch bachche apne aap ko physically bahut sochte hain ki hum bahut taakatwar hain. Lekin jab baat aati hai public speaking ki ya aage chalkar bolne ki, to wahan par dekhte hain ki are hamare haath shiver kar rahe hain, hum tremble kar rahe hain, hum bol nahi pa rahe hain. तो जब हम स्ट्रेंथ की बात करते हैं, स्ट्रेंथ दोनों तरह से होनी चाहिए, फिजिकल और मेंटल, उसे हम स्ट्रेंथ कहते हैं. बैठिए अपने साथ और लिखिए कि मेरे में क्या क्या स्ट्रेंथ्स हैं. आप कोई बोलेगा कि मैं दिखता अच्छा हूं, तो वो भी उसको स्ट्रेंथ लगती है, तो वो स्ट्रेंथ है. जिस चीज को आप परसीव करते हैं कि वो मेरा पॉजिटिव पॉइंट है, मेरा स्ट्रेंथ है, उसको लिखिए स्ट्रेंथ है. ऐसे में आप अपने आप के साथ जब बैठेंगे तो आपको अपने बारे में विशेषण होगा, आपको पता चलेगा कि आपके में विशेष चीजें क्या हैं, आपके अंदर क्या ऐसी चीजें हैं जो आपको सबसे अलग घोषित करती हैं, साबित करती हैं. अब हम बात करते हैं वीकनेस की. लोग जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल आपको मैं एक बात और बताऊं, पॉजिटिव जब हम बात करते हैं पॉजिटिव चीजों की, तो बहुत लोग कहते हैं, बहुत बच्चे कहते हैं कि मैम मैं रिस्पेक्ट करता हूँ बड़ों की, क्या उसको स्ट्रेंथ माना जाएगा? डेफिनेटली माना जाएगा. जब आप बड़ों की रिस्पेक्ट करते हैं, आप डिसिप्लिन्ड हैं, आप डेडिकेटेड हैं, आप क्रिएटिव हैं, आप पेशेंट हैं, तो आपके अंदर ये सारी खूबियां हैं, इनको खूबियों को स्ट्रेंथ ही माना जाएगा. बच्चे सुबह उठते हैं, बहुत से बच्चे होते हैं जैसे स्कूल लेवल में जब हम ट्रेनिंग लेते हैं तो हम बोलते हैं कि आप में से कितने बच्चे ऐसे हैं जो उठकर सुबह अपना बेड लगाते हैं, तो आधे बच्चे होते हैं वो कहते हैं हम तो नहीं लगाते, हमारे मम्मी पापा लगाते हैं. अब ये जो चीज है अपना काम स्वयं करना, ये भी एक बहुत बड़ा स्ट्रेंथ है आज की डेट में, ठीक है. अब हम बात करते हैं वीकनेस की. अब वीकनेस क्या है? ऑब्वियसली जब स्ट्रेंथ ये है तो वीकनेस उससे ऑपोजिट ही होगा. जो भी डिक्रीज करेगा आपकी स्ट्रेंथ को वो वीकनेस होगा. जिससे आपको लॉस फेस करना पड़ेगा वो आपकी वीकनेस होगा. कैसे? जैसे कुछ बच्चे बोलते हैं अपने स्कूल्स वगैरह में, मैम हम लोग ना टाइम से उठ नहीं पाते हैं. तो अगर 20 बच्चे मान लीजिए, मतलब अगर पूरे स्कूल में आप देखेंगे कि स्कूल के गेट के बाहर हमेशा 10 से 20 बच्चे हमेशा बाहर खड़े होंगे लेट कमर्स की लाइन में. 10 से 20 बच्चे जो है लेट कमर्स की लाइन में खड़े होंगे. क्यों खड़े होंगे? क्योंकि ये उसको वीकनेस को एक्सेप्ट कर लिया उन्होंने कि हम लेट आते हैं स्कूल में तो और हम नहीं सुबह उठ पाते हैं, ये हमारी वीकनेस है. मैम क्या करें, हम सुबह उठ ही नहीं पाते हैं. अब बात करते हैं, जब आप लिखेंगे ये सारे पॉइंट्स स्ट्रेंथ्स और वीकनेस के, अपने आप से एकदम ऑनेस्ट होके लिखिएगा. उसके बाद हम थर्ड पॉइंट जो आते हैं वो है अपॉर्चुनिटीज. अब आप कहेंगे ये अपॉर्चुनिटी क्या है? व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय अपॉर्चुनिटी? अपॉर्चुनिटी का मतलब होता है कि जो भी चांसेस और चेंजेस आप अपनी लाइफ में लाना चाहते हैं, जो भी सर्कमस्टांसेस आपकी लाइफ में आते हैं, क्या आप उसको अपने लिए बेस्ट यूज कर पाएंगे? दैट इज व्हाट इज कॉल्ड एज अपॉर्चुनिटी, राइट? नाउ आई विल टॉक अबाउट अनदर पॉइंट, दैट इज थ्रेट्स. व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट SWOT एनालिसिस, वी आल्सो टॉक अबाउट थ्रेट्स. थ्रेट्स क्या होंगे? एनी पॉइंट्स, एनी थिंग्स, एनी सिचुएशंस. फॉर एग्जांपल, अभी वी हैव अ पेंडेमिक एंड आई टोल्ड यू वी ऑल हैव अवर ओन पेंडेमिक ब्लूज. यू मे हैव सर्टन थिंग्स, सर्टन एप्रीहेंशंस, सर्टन डेंजर विच यू परसीव एंड दे यू थिंक दे माइट डैमेज योर करियर. दीज थ्रेट्स, दीज इंजरीज, दीज डैमेजेस, वॉट यू परसीव राइट नाउ. Okay, some people also might think, I live in a small area, in a rural area, and I don't think I will have much opportunities because I live in a rural area. That is a threat which you have perceived. That is something which is impeding your growth. That is something which is impeding your development, right? So please, when you write all these, all strengths, weakness, opportunities, threats, make it as honest as possible. Write whatever you feel like writing. There is no judgment about it. Nobody will judge you for this. It has to be totally your own portfolio, which you will keep with you. You will share with your teacher. We will help you. Your teacher, I'm sure, will help you in finding out various other solutions to this. Whatever help they can render, they will help you. But this has to be a very honest, introspective document for you, because this has to be something which you have to keep it with yourself. Now let me move to the next slide. Itna time on. Okay, now we will talk about benefits of SWOT analysis. As I told you, ke ye jo hum analysis kar rahe hain, jo SWOT analysis hum log kar rahe hain, iske piche hamara kya, aaj jo main aapse mil rahi hu aur ye jo workshop ho rahi hai, iske piche hamara kya karan hai कि हम क्यों चाहते हैं कि आपको आपके अपने बारे में पता हो, दैट यू नो योर सेल्फ. सी वाई वी वॉन्ट दिस थिंग इज बिकॉज अल्टीमेटली वी आर देयर एज अ फेसिलिटेटर, एज अ हेल्पर, सो दैट वी कैन हेल्प यू टू अचीव योर ऑप्टिमम लेवल, योर बेंच मार्क, वट एवर यू हैव डिसाइडेड फॉर योर सेल्फ. सो वट इज द बेनिफिट? इट बूस्ट कॉन्फिडेंस. यू हैव टू, इट हेल्प्स यू टू प्रिपेयर फॉर योर फ्यूचर एंड योर करियर प्रॉस्पेक्ट्स एंड अपॉर्चुनिटीज. इट ऑल्सो हेल्प्स यू टू get awards, because just for example, if I have a fear of public speaking, I don't want to speak, I don't want to get in front of the public and speak. So what do we do? We as teachers, we as facilitators, we as educators, how can we help you? We will give you opportunities so that you can get over your fear, right? So now next is, it also, your daily output also is also affected if you have a proper SWOT analysis. What happens is, like, if there are a few children, even we as adults also face such problems, like getting up in the morning is a big problem. So what do we do? So there are a lot of children, there are a lot of kids, there are a lot of students who come up with this problem, like, ma'am, getting up is a big problem. My mama comes and she comes and says, utho, utho, 10 times she comes and 11th time I get up. And then also early morning, what happens is unpleasantness. So what do we do? So for them, like I told them, that you have a strategy of 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So whenever you feel that you are unable to do any task, just start counting reverse. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and you get up. That's all. That's the only strategy. You have to condition your mind. You have to train your mind to be more powerful, to gain strength. Now, because of this SWOT analysis, in your case, when we talk about engineering students, the prime focus is that we want to get you employed in a good place, in a dream company, so-called dream company, which you all have. I am sure all of you must have one dream company in your mind where you want to go and you want to be employed. So if this SWOT analysis will help you in getting better employability, that is the main focus. Now it also helps in upscaling and upskilling your technical skills. Upscaling and upskilling are two different things. What do you do when you upskill? You upskill means you try to enhance your skills. You are upskilling yourself, up and skilling, right? So then for this, SWOT analysis is very beneficial because you come to know about your weaknesses. For example, I have a limitation of speaking in English. So what do you do? What is the remedy? The remedial thing is that you start reading newspaper, you start reading storybooks, you start watching videos on YouTube. See, it's all about time management, what you want to do in life. The time is limited. We all have limited time. Whether you want to watch Ranbir Kapoor or whether you want to watch a YouTube blog on this thing, language, that's your choice. because we are made up of our own choices, basically. Okay, next. Again, the same thing, since I'm talking to children who are young professionals. So career readiness and SWOT. So my the purpose of bringing this SWOT analysis was that you should be career ready. And as I've written, India Skills Report says that employability of Indian graduates across sectors is projected to dip. As you know, we have a pandemic. I don't know how many years will it take to revive from this pandemic. With a lot of unemployment rate, with a lot of pandemic related problems, the burnt out effect of this pandemic will last for so many years. So what do we need to do? We need to demonstrate lifelong learning skills by continuously acquiring industry related information and improving professional skills. You are all electrical students. You should be aware of what is happening in your electrical domain as such by being googling it, by watching videos. What I feel the problem with nowadays is that we don't know what content to watch in our mobile. We all have mobiles in our hand, but the only thing which we are not aware of is that what is the content which I should watch. Entertainment ke liye bahut sources hai, TV bhi hai, mobile bhi hai, aapke paas music bhi hai, but us entertainment ka kitna matra aapko daily doses lena hai, wo aapko pata hona chahiye. And a 360 degree holistic self analysis. Aajkal hum log baat karte hain 360 degree feedback. Hum logon ko, ab hamare teachers bhi agar thoda sa feedback deti hain, then we feel offended. We should not feel offended. We should be very open to it. We should welcome it because that gives us a chance of improvement. So SWOT analysis, that is why I told analysis of any kind can be done only when you get a feedback. So SWOT analysis is a feedback which you are giving to yourself. This is feedback given by you to yourself. So SWOT analysis help us to enhance our skills. Apart from personal qualities such as interpersonal skills, these are all personal qualities: honesty, reliability, integrity, and positive work, motivation. We need to prepare ourselves fully with soft skills. Now, nowadays there is a lot of hype of soft skills, which we say employers, they want soft skills in their employees. They want that we should get a full package of personality, knowledge, and intellect, and behavioral skills also up to the mark. So when we talk about this soft skills, what is the expectation of an employer is that we should have good communication skills, reading, writing skills, critical thinking and problem solving. जब हम thinking skills की बात करते हैं तो उसमें basically जब हम एक team में काम करते हैं तो हम कैसे problem solve करते हैं इस पर बहुत depend करता है. और सबसे जो मैंने बोला ये सारी skills जो मैंने आपको बताई हैं, ये जब आप SWOT analysis करेंगे तो आपको अपने अंदर की ये सारी skills का भी पता चलेगा. फॉर एग्ज़ाम्पल जब हम बैठेंगे अपने बारे में एनालिसिस करने कि हमारा कैसा टाइम मैनेजमेंट है, हमारी मैथमेटिकल स्किल्स कैसी हैं, क्योंकि ये स्किल सेट अगर आपको पता है अपना, अगर आपने अपनी खुद स्किल मैपिंग कर रखी है, अपना स्किल सेट से आप खुद अवेयर हैं, तो आपको एम्प्लॉयर्स को कन्विंस करने में टाइम नहीं लगेगा. सबसे पहले हमें अपने आप को कन्विंस करना है कि चीज़ें मेरे अंदर हैं. अगर ये चीज़ें मेरे अंदर हैं तो दूसरों को कन्विंस करने में हमें टाइम नहीं लगेगा कि ये चीज़ें हमारे अंदर हैं. जैसे कि आप हर एक जगह पे जहाँ पे आप जाते हैं वहाँ लोग पूछते हैं कि अपनी स्ट्रेंथ्स और वीकनेस के बारे में लिखिए, तो हम एकदम लॉस्ट हो जाते हैं. क्या लिखना है भाई, हमारे में क्या वीकनेस है? कुछ बोलते हैं हम तो बिल्कुल परफेक्ट है, हमारे में कोई वीकनेस ही नहीं है. और कुछ लोग सोचते हैं कि अरे मेरे में तो वीकनेस है, स्ट्रेंथ ही नहीं है. बिकॉज ये हमारी अपनी सेल्फ इमेज पे बहुत डिपेंड करता है. कभी हम अपने साथ बैठे और अपना एनालिसिस करें, अपने बारे में स्वॉट करें, तो हमें पता चलता है कि हमारे अंदर ये वीकनेस है और ये स्ट्रेंथ है. और अगर हम खुद कन्विंस्ड हैं कि ये हमारी स्ट्रेंथ है तो हमारे को किसी और को कन्विंस करने का जरूरत ही नहीं है. वी आर टोटली कन्विंस्ड अबाउट दैट. ओके, नेक्स्ट वी गो टू द नेक्स्ट वन. हाँ, जैसे कि मैंने स्किल मैपिंग की अभी बात करी आपसे. स्किल मैपिंग क्या होती है? स्किल मैपिंग है कि हमें पता है, वी आर श्योर अबाउट वॉट आर अवर पॉजिटिव, वॉट आर अवर स्ट्रेंथ्स. हाँ, एंड जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल वर्क एक्सपीरियंस और टेक्निकल एक्सपर्टीज और something like a personal character, like, for example, I'm very caring, I'm very honest. That is also my strength. So competency, we also call it competency in HR, and skill mapping identifies an individual's strength and weakness. The aim is to enable the person to better understand himself or herself and point out where career development efforts are needed to be directed. See, the ultimate goal is, I told you that we want a dream job in a dream company, right? That's what ultimate aim is. We want to get employed. Few of us are not so keen to be employed. They want to be an entrepreneur and they want to set up their own company. They want to set up their own whatever they want to. But the thing is that whatever is your long-term goal, your short-term goal also should be aligned to it. And how do you make your short-term goal? Short-term goal can only be made when you are self-aware, when you know where you're leading, when you know what mistakes you have done and what is the improvement plan. Now, skills mapping refers to creating a visual representation of skills needed to perform well in any given role, or comparing that with this existing skills held by the students. For example, mere paas abhi skill hai ek, ke meri communication skills bahut achhi hai, but mera interpersonal acha nahi hai. Main logon se na team mein kaam nahi kar pati hu. Mere logon ke sath problem ho jata hai, kyunki mujhe lagta hai ki mera acknowledgement koi aur le raha hai. So if I am aware of this fact, ultimately when I have to work with a lot of people around me. So what do? You start working on that area. See, whenever you see there is a skill gap, wherever you see is cheez ke karan main maat khane wala hu ya khane wali hu, mujhe abhi se is cheez pe kaam karna hai. See, ultimately nobody will help you. You yourself can help yourself better. You may find facilitators, you may find a lot of people around you, but then they can only facilitate you. The task lies on you. And as there is an old saying also, ke we have to help ourselves. So in a professional environment where you are wanted, where it is a requirement that you have to multitask, what is happening is nowadays in pandemic also, you see your teachers, a lot of your mother and everybody doing multitasking. Professionally also they are doing, and household work, because women are born multitaskers. So in a professional environment where you are supposed to be a multitasker, in a competitive environment where you're supposed to perform constantly, what happens is that if you have a proper knowledge of your skills and your skill gaps, your performance level increases. And once your performance level increases, you outshine, you are visible, your visibility also increases. Okay, now let me go to the next slide. Okay, I think I am on time. And what is the time right now?
12:10.
So I would also like to say one thing, that since all of us are in such a times where we have to learn to manage ourselves effectively, and that's the most essential skill what we need to have right now, because we as educators and facilitators are preparing you for your future. And for that, if you have these type of interactions, and when you can sit with yourself and just 5-10 minutes of self work and think what you want to achieve in your life, and do something for yourself, that will be something which will be very fruitful, because you know, developing those values and habits and developing such things will lead you to the desired behavior what you want. And I am really glad that I was given a chance to talk to you. I don't remember whether I've written my email or not, but I would that's on the first slide. And I would also want that children should give me a feedback to this, whether they've liked this session or not. And Arushi is always available whenever anybody wants to talk to me. You're free to do that, because we are there to help you out in your journey. And we want you to have your dream job in your dream company and achieve whatever you want, and prepare your future so well that when you are actually into that game of competition, you win. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I would like.
Video on color.
Sorry, my mobile also. I would like to thank Mrs. Neetu. Thank you very much for your wonderful session on the skill activities, analysis, and most important, I like the thinking skills and assessing our learning style, whether kinesthetic or visual. That is most important. When we will know our learning style, it will help a lot. So I would like to request all students, whatever madam has said, you just think on that, start working. And I would like to request Arushi also, just go on sharing with her mother whatever activities we are doing in class, and to have her contribution, suggestions also. So you just go on sharing, both of you. And dear students, you can also go on sharing with madam, so that I hope that our relationship will continue more 3 years. So thank you, madam. Thanks.
Thank you so much. And I am very, very happy to see that you are making initiative for developing them, in the sense that what education system we have, we know it's a multi-level teaching, because a lot of children with different varieties, a lot of children with different aptitude, abilities, they're all in one class. So what happens is that if we have a mentor, if we have a teacher, if we have somebody to facilitate us, then we can always have a good result. Thank you so much for calling me today. Thank you so much.
Yes, thank you. Dear students, have a good day.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.